Hi everyone, it's Lily from Lily's Mix. Today I just mixed up a couple of artist colors. These two, this was is transparent, and this is of course opaque white, and this one I added white to a transparent color because I wanted to create some sort of harmony. This is cheap Nicole's orange, just mixed with my DIY pouring medium, 3-to-1 PVA glue. So I have 3 ounces of PVA glue to 1 ounce of water. I haven't added my silicone, which of course is this heavy duty silicone. You can get it in auto supply stores or one of the big box stores. So I'm going to add my silicone. I'm going to add it to all the colors. And here we go, just a squirt there. Ooh, that's a lot. Just a couple drops there, a couple drops there, and a little there, and a little there. Okay, so some of the ones I'm going to stir a lot and some a little, so I have varied cells. So let's see. Let's stir that one a lot because I put way too much in it. Looks like the paint's kind of thick. So I'll just use a lot of paint to cover this 6x6 canvas. So orange still like that. This one will just stir a little. This one a little bit. And I'm gonna start with white and pour my way around. Okay, so I hope that worked well enough. I dropped my popsicle sticks right in the soapy water. Oh, and here's my cup. I'm gonna start with white today. I usually try to change it up. So there's my white. Put quite a bit in there. Maybe the whole thing. Okay, right here. I always keep soapy water by my side so it's less mess. I'm gonna pour this one from up high. Let's see how this one is. It's transparent. Quinacridone crimson. Okay, put that one to the side. This is a little bit of transparent yellow and regular yellow mixed. See how my reaction's going in the cup. Looks like it'll be all right. And some orange. I hope I put enough silicone in there. Maybe get a little more. Stick out of here, less mess. That should be enough. And this color, I don't know if I should put this in. It's kind of a weird color. It's kind of a creamy, little bit of a yuck color, huh? I think that should more than cover the canvas. Let's see what else I have left. This will give it more definition, this nice dark color. Okay, now I'm gonna do, I don't know, maybe a side pour. Ooh, it looks yummy in there. Let's see what I can get out of the white. I like to shut my camera off at this point, and sometimes I like to do a flip cup and do it in slow-mo. I think they're fun to watch that way. Okay. Okay. My canvas is up on thumbtacks. Here we go. This is my first time with very strange colors. I'm gonna go straight up with Mackenzie. Here we go. Creamy, yummy. It looks like a popsicle. Looks like it's a little to one side. We have some cells popping. I think it looks yummy. Let it move a little bit. Let it get thinned out just a little. It's pretty level. I don't have anything really strong anywhere, so I may just do this. One thing I hate. I hate the little trailer where everybody knows where you, what you did. So I'll just go like this. Cover up the drip edge. Push my canvas forward. I like it now. Kind of. Oh, that one on the carpet. Did you hear that? I got a little too close. Gotta get something going on here. I think the colors are all muted. There's not enough contrast. So if I can, I'm gonna give a little definition. There's a lot of paint on there. That's a little better. Now it's got a, now it has a, you know, the rule of thirds, the golden rule in painting, now it has that. It's got something to look at. I like it now. Okay, I'm gonna finish the sides off screen. I don't want this to be an exceptionally long video. You see basically what I did. You know that I used silicone. I stirred some of the colors fast in a lot, and some of the colors I just did a little bit of so that I would get big cells. Let me see what else. Not much. Okay, thank you for watching, and please subscribe to Lily's Mix. Thank you.